I got a question for you. You about that chub life? What's going on, Headliner Nation? Jake Fantasy Headliners. Hopefully everybody's doing well out there. And you heard it in the opening. This episode, we're talking about that chub life. Are you about that chub life this year? I mean, who's with me? We used the hashtag last year. Who wants to use it again in 2019? Give me chub. Give me chub again in 2019. Gotta be careful who I say that to. But there's a lot of reasons why I still like Nick Chubb. If you're new to this channel and you're sick of boring fantasy football talk, you found the right place. Let's have some fun talking some fantasy football. And I would really appreciate if you guys would be out there. Hit that like button. Hit the subscribe button. It really helps us out here on YouTube. Let's get into a few reasons why, though, I'm still about this Chubb life. All right, so let's get into it. I'm going to keep the hat and the sunglasses on. Why? A, it's my show, and B, I kind of feel like I'm letting it flow, and I feel like I haven't let it flow for a while, so we're going to get into it. If you don't know what Let It Flow is, I'm sorry. You need to check it out. I'm about to go a little bit crazy on you and talk really fast, but that's what happens when we have some fun with fantasy football. All right, diving into Nick Chubb now. If you go check out fantasyfootballcalculator.com, it's the site we use. We're partnered with them to get a lot of our preseason, offseason, you know, information and data collection from. Right now, his current ADP is 21, which means he's a late second, early third round pick, depending on your league size. That is great value, and it may get even better the closer we get to the season. When a lot of the redraft crowd comes back and really starts focusing on fantasy football, they may also be scared of the whole Kareem Hunt situation, causing this ADP to get even later. If it does, that's great for you. Why? Because everybody is draftable. I'm sick of seeing articles and videos out there with people saying, don't draft this guy and don't draft this guy. A, it's only April. We have no idea what's about to happen until August. But B, everybody is draftable. Don't go into your draft saying, I will not draft this guy. Unless you have some personal bias against him, like maybe he took your girlfriend from you in high school. Other than that, everybody has draft value at a certain price. For example, Antonio Brown's name comes up a lot. Do not draft Antonio Brown. A lot of people are saying that. Well, do you want to draft Antonio Brown in the first round? No, you don't. If he slips to the third, do you want to take him? Yeah, he may be worth that gamble. That's why everybody has draft value. That's one of my biggest tips for your fantasy football drafts. Don't go in there and have a plan beforehand. Take what the draft gives you and build a solid roster. Now, let's talk about Nick Chubb as a rookie. He had a great rookie season. He rushed for just under 1,000 yards, 996 yards, 8 touchdowns, caught another 149 yards and 2 touchdowns. A great stat. He had 0 fumbles. 0 as in nil, none, nada, nothing. He actually protects the ball quite well for a young rookie running back, and that's definitely what you want. You don't want something like that, you know, going against him and possibly causing him to lose carries at any point of the season. He didn't even take over the starting job full-time until week 7. Remember, Carlos Hyde was kind of in the mix. If you take his numbers, though, from week 7 on and project them over a 16-game season, dude would have rushed for 1,317 yards, 10 touchdowns, caught another 238 yards, and 4 touchdowns. That is RB1 numbers right there, hands down, and the team is even better this year. Another couple fun stats out there. He ranked 6th in breakaway runs. Breakaway run. There we go. That is considered anything over 15 plus yards. He had 14 of those in 2018. He also ranked 9th in evaded tackles. So, you know, able to not just break a tackle, but evade the tackle with 64 of them. He ranked 10th in carries that were facing a stacked box, with 29% of his carries facing 8 defenders in the box. With those 8 defenders in the box, he averaged 4.5 yards per carry, among some of the league best, like I said, ranked 10th overall. Not even taking over to week 7, and getting numbers like this is absolutely mind-boggling of what this guy could do this coming season. All right, so with all those stats considered, we have ourselves a solid running back 1 for a minimum of 8 weeks-ish. I don't expect Kareem Hunt to just come back and take the job away. There may be a split of some sort, but it's going to take him a few weeks to get acclimated into that offense, and by that time, the bulk of your fantasy football season has already finished. There's also rumors going on that Duke Johnson could get traded. If he's traded here in the offseason, how much more does that boost the value of a Nick Chubb for those first 8, 9, 10 games, whatever it end up may being? this is definitely a huge, huge value for you for somebody that you could possibly get in the third round. I mean, yes, I understand. There is that chance that when Hunt comes back, this goes into a more of a split, you know, backfield. I understand that, but let's be realistic. Majority of the teams out there are all split backfields. There's very, very few, you know, workhorse running backs out there anymore. Now, there's already some beat writers out there saying that even when Hunt returns, Nick Chubb will still remain the starter in this offense. He will still get the bulk of the carries, that Hunt may take more of a third down role, which I know sounds crazy because Kareem Hunt, you know, when inserted in an offense, is an absolutely elite running back. I understand that. But I'm also not going to avoid Chubb because of it. This is too much talent at a great price. I'm not going to go up there and reach for him and take him early. He's going to fall in drafts. People are going to pass on him because of this whole Kareem Hunt situation. Let them pass on him. You take the great value later on and reap the benefits, especially when there's guys around him that already have risks, right? The running backs that are surrounding him right there at that current ADP, Damian Williams. Well, what's going to happen there with Carlos Hyde? We really don't know yet. Leonard Fournette. Dude can't stay healthy at all. Sony Michel. Love Sony Michel. Don't love that there's 412 running backs in New England. Derrick Henry. Yes, ended the year on a hot streak. A lot of people are worried about that potential price being too high to take Henry this year. Like I'm saying, there's others, you know, just to name a few here that really have these same concerns. So why not go out there, get somebody with the solid RB1 upside that you know can do it from an early basis and get yourself out to an early lead here in fantasy football. It's all about wins and losses. You want to win. I want to win those first 8, 9, 10 games of the season. If Nick Chubb can help me win those first 8, 9, 10 games of the season, I'm going to be happy. And there's no way that he's going to face stacked boxes on a weekly basis here in Cleveland. There's no way. Not with this offense. Odell Beckham, Jarvis Landry, David Njoku, Antonio Callaway, Rashard Higgins. I mean, there's people all over the place. Love some Baker Mayfield this year. They're not going to be able to stack the box to take away Nick Chubb because they have too many weapons on the outside. This offense will be one of the best in football. The defense has playmakers all over the field. They could be playing with a lot more second half leads, which only boosts the value of a Nick Chubb more. Look at it this way, and this is how I'm kind of going to end it. Injuries can happen at any possible time, right? You could lose your stud RB1 at any time. Doesn't matter. Injuries happen everywhere. This is kind of considered like a planned injury. You know that there is risk coming around week 9, 10-ish. Plan for it. Hit that waiver wire. If you have fab budget, whatever it is, go out there and get yourself a solid running back. Or during the draft, take some guys with some potential, you know, late season, potential there that could really help you if something does go downhill for Nick Chubb. You know about it ahead of time. It will not catch you off guard if in week 9 or 10, he goes out there and gets single-digit carries. You've kind of planned for it. You're ready for it. You've benefited from it for the first 9, 10 weeks. Go out there, make a solid plan for him, and reap the benefits of a Nick Chubb for 9 or 10 weeks. I really love Nick Chubb. Yes, I know. This is not the most ideal situation, but take it for what it's worth. Get that value on draft day. Reap the benefits for the first few weeks of the season. Make a solid draft plan and plans through free agent and through the waiver wire. Make sure that you're ready to go just in case something were to happen, and you're going to be just fine. I still like Nick Chubb. Let's hope that ADP drops even more. The more people who get scared about it, the happier that I get about getting Chubb. I love Nick Chubb this season still. Don't avoid him altogether. Do not reach for Nick Chubb. That sounds weird too. Don't reach for his Chubb. All right, but you know what I mean. He still has great value out there. Don't just write him off because other people are writing an article or putting out a video saying just because of Kareem Hunt. That's not the greatest of arguments. It's all about wins and losses. Like I said, we're all about getting some wins over here. But I want to know yours. What is your opinion on this situation? Are you just going to write it off and say, you know what? Not even dealing with it. Are you going to take some of these facts and stuff that we talked about Nick Chubb and apply them to your draft and maybe he falls to you and then you're all of a sudden you're open to it? I want to know your opinion. Share it down below. I love to interact with you guys. One of the most interactive channels on YouTube, and we don't just say that. We respond to almost every single comment we get. No other YouTube channels out there are going to do that. And we do that because we're trying to build the community. We're trying to make sure that you guys know that you have a voice. This is fantasy football for everybody, not just for me. Let's have some fun with it. Looking forward to it. Like I said, if you're new here, put a comment down below. If you've subscribed to the channel, I'd like to welcome you to Headliner Nation personally myself. And other than that, we greatly appreciate your support. Have a great rest of your week. Head to our website, check out the draft kit. They're available for pre-order, and we will look forward to talking to you later. Peace.